angles, vertically opposite angles. In this, see, what is the definition for vertical opposite angles? When two lines intersect, if you take two lines, for example, this is one line and this is one line. Yes or no? This is one line and this is one line. But what they are saying, when two lines intersect, intersect means they have to join. So we have to take the two lines. We have to take two lines. Okay, when you are taking two lines intersect, then the angles that are formed opposite to each other means, see, here we got it one angle and here we got it one angle. Okay, for this angle, this is the opposite side. For this angle, this is the opposite side. Yes or no? For this, this is the opposite side. For this side, this is the opposite side. So, what they are saying, when two lines intersect, intersect means they have to join, intersect. The angles that are formed opposite to each other means opposite to each other. At a point of intersection, when it is a intersection point, what we are calling vertex. The center point we are calling as vertex. Okay, na? That vertex are called the vertical opposite angles. Those two angles are called vertical opposite angles. Okay, this is we are taking one line and here we are taking one line. Na? By taking two lines, we are forming angles here. Okay, at this, it is same point, means same vertex we are using and we are getting two angles, the opposite angles. For this opposite, this side. For this opposite, this side. Yes or no? So, that's why if you take here 4, for example, if you take here 1, next here 2, means 1, 2, these two are opposite angles. Suppose if you take here 3, this is 4. 3, 4 are vertical opposite angles. Okay, na? For 1, what is opposite angle? 2. For 3, what is opposite angle? 4. Okay, 1, 2 are vertical opposite angles, 3, 4 are vertical opposite angles. Okay, children, do you understand the definition? Now, by using this, we will do the sums. Okay, now, let us see the first one. What is the question they have given, Anna? Name two pairs of vertically opposite angles in the figure. Now, what is the figure they have given? Children, this is the figure they have given. Now, see, by observing this figure, we had to find out vertical opposite angles. Okay, now, by observing this figure, we can see two angles, two pairs we can observe. What are those? See, by seeing from like this and like this. If you close this one, it is opposite or not? Opposite angles or not? We can observe like this. Into symbol we can observe or not? Yes. So, here we can form one angle and here we can form another angle. If you close this one. See. Now, what What is the angle we got it here, Nana? Angle AOD, comma angle COB. Angle COB. This is one pair of vertical opposite angle. Next, another one. Where we can observe? When you observe, see. Ear and ear. Close this one. See, when you are closing, we can see. Yes or no? Ear and ear. So, what are the angles? When you keep the angle here, what are the arms we got in A, O, C? When? C, D, O, B. For this angle, what are the arms? D, O, B. Okay, so write that one. A, O, C, comma, D, O, B. These are the two pairs of the angles we got it. Okay, children? Again, I am repeating once again. See. Name two pairs of vertical opposite angles in the figure. In this figure, we had to find out the vertical opposite angles. Okay? Now, by observing this figure, see, if you close this one, we can observe here one angle and here one angle. Means, by using this angle, what are the arms we got it? A, O, C. For this angle, what are the arms we got it? D, O, B or B, O, D. We can write any one. So, that one we got it. Next, another angle where we are forming ear and ear. But when you are using this angle, what are the arms we got it? A, O, D. For this angle, what are the arms we got it? C, O, B. Okay, so those I have written. Okay, children, you understand? Now, let us see the next one. See the second one. What is the second question they have given? Find the measure of x comma y comma and z without actually measuring them. What is the figure they have given? So here y, here 160 degrees, here x, here z. Okay, children? This is a question they have given. See, again I am repeating. Find the measure of x, y and z. Here they have given three variables. What are the variables they have given? X, y, z. Okay. Now we have to find out the x value, y value, z value. Okay. Now, without the actual measuring them, we should not measure. Actually, we have to test. Okay. For this now, let us see the sum. Now, what is the first one they have already I told? For this angle, what is the opposite side? 160 is the opposite side. So, y angle y equal to 160 degrees. Angle y equal to 160 degrees. Means vertically opposite angle. Okay, na? Y equal to 160 degrees. Angle y equal to 160 degrees. Why we have taken? For angle y, what is the vertical opposite angle? 160 is the vertical opposite angle. So that's why angle y equal to 160 degrees I have taken. Same process for angle x. What is the opposite vertical angle? Angle z is the opposite vertical angle. So angle x equal to angle z. Angle x equal to angle z. So write here. Vertically opposite angle. Okay, now hence angle x equal to angle x plus 160 degrees equal to 180 degrees. So what is the linear pair of an angle and a 180 degrees? So write here linear pair of linear pair angle. Okay, now I want x value. So what I have to do? 160 I have to take to RHS. So angle x equal to 180 degrees minus 160 degrees. So how much we got it? 20 degrees. So angle x value how much I got it? 20 degrees means angle x equal to 20. Means angle x means angle z also 20 degrees only, no? So therefore angle x angle y equal to 20 degrees. Sorry, angle z. Angle z equal to 20 degrees. Angle y equal to already we learned 160 degrees. Now add these two three numbers, we'll get 180 or not. See, check yourself. See. Yes, we got it. By adding these two numbers, 160, 20. How much we got it? 180 we got it. Okay, children, do you understand what is the x value we got it? 20 degrees. Angle z equal to 20 degrees. Angle y equal to 160 degrees. Okay, children, you understand the second sum. Now let us see the third one. Vertically opposite angles in your surroundings. Give some examples of vertical opposite angles in your surroundings. Vertically opposite sides means this is you had to write yourself, Nana. Angle between, I am telling the examples for you. In a scissor, plates of a scissor, angle between a plates of a scissor, we can write it. See, angle between plates of a scissor, plates of a scissor, like this. Again, for a fan, we can observe. Okay? Like this, we have to write your own sentences. Okay? Angle between plates of a scissor. If you take a scissor, how it is? It is in like this. Yes or no? When you are observing this one, we can see here, we can find out the vertical opposite angles. Like that, we have to take some more examples. So, children, you had to find out and you had to write your own sentence. Okay, children, in the next class we'll see some more sums. Next topic is transversal. We'll see in the next class, children. Okay.